calling this a niche film per se, you know, compared to mainstream films. But if you go to see, whatever Aamir does is not considered niche. So why, you know, is Dhobi Ghat being called a niche film in that sense?
Well, actually, that defines the genre of the film. I mean, when you actually look at the style of filmmaking, of storytelling,
right.
The kind of devices, non-linear narrative and things like that that we've used, they aren't your typical, you know, commercial formulaic cinema.
Right.
And while, you know, Aamir does things hatke always and people are expecting things different from him, this is really quite out of the box. I mean, right. It's not in the same playing ground as these hatke films.
Right.
It's in another ballpark. So that's why we've been saying it, because audiences here aren't accustomed to watching films like this. We don't have them made in India. So it's really, you know, it is a niche film, and we would like people to know what they're going in to see.
Right.
It's also, I mean, as a result of, I believe that we should be responsible and honest to our audience.
Right.
Because actually it's very easy for us to pretend that it's one of my other kind of other films. Because people, it's coming after Three Idiots. I've had a string of successes. So we can have a very big opening and, you know, the film has cost us very less. So we can make a lot of money and, you know, forget about it. But according to me, that's not a responsible way to behave with the audience. I think that my relationship with the audience is one which I hold very dear and I value a lot. And I feel that when they come to see a film of mine, I want them to know what kind of film it is.
Right.
And I want them to have the choice whether they want to see this film or not.
Right.
Maybe it's a film that they don't want to see. You know, some people want to see very entertaining films, which are very fast-paced, which have got a lot of action perhaps, or a lot of entertainment value, a lot of humor perhaps, comedy. It's not that kind of film.
Okay.
So I want people to know that it's not that kind of film. Because then, if they feel ki haan par humko nahi dekhna, at least they can take their choice.
Right.
I don't want to fool anyone
right.
by bringing him in.
And so, neither is it a message-based film.
It's got no message in it. You know, it's not like some message is there in the film or something. It's a very delicate story about characters and life and, you know, feelings. I mean, I think it's very good.
Right.
But I don't want people to have wrong impression and come in with the wrong impression.
Right. So Kiran, what inspired you to make this story, and what, you know, what was the first thought, you know, how did the germ of the idea of the movie come into your mind?
I was looking for, you know, a subject that I thought I could make into my first film that really gave me something to chew on, and you know, one of the main core of the idea was really that I wanted to make a film about Mumbai, and I felt that this is a city that has inspired me for so many years, has taught me so much, has given me so much. And in some ways, it's such an interesting character. You know, it feels like it's a character by itself. There's so much complexity, so many layers, that it's really something that you can explore beautifully through film.
Right.
That was my starting point. And then, you know, the idea of these four characters who represent different parts of the city, different kinds of backgrounds and lifestyles and classes. You know, was woven into the story.
But you never felt you were taking a risk by making a film which was not like, you know, mainstream popular Bollywood cinema?
You know,
moreover, because it's your debut.
I know. I guess I've never really wanted to. My aim in making a film has always been to figure out what I can do. You know, what's my forte, what's my voice as an artist, as a creative person, as a filmmaker. What is my distinctive voice? Do I have something to say? These are things that make me want to make film. I mean, I'm not really making a film because I want to make a first film.
Right.
I'm making a film because I feel like I have something to contribute. And I wouldn't make it if I didn't think it was something good. I mean, so when I wrote it, I didn't have box office in mind. I didn't have audience. I had nobody but myself looking over my own shoulder to see, is it good? Is it worth making? Do I have a story to tell? And that's what I set out to do. So it turned out like this. It was never an intention that, oh, I'd want to do something that's not mainstream, or I want to make art house.
Right. So, you know, we've read about how your approach to filming this movie was very realistic, you know, guerrilla style filming and everything. How difficult was it for you as an actor as a director? You know, what are the difficulties you faced, or how was the process? Because it was very different.
It was. I think one of our main struggles was finding locations because shooting in Mumbai is a challenge. It's not the easiest place to shoot in. One, because there's so many people all the time everywhere. And second, because locking off or doing things within a certain area, given that there's so much crowd, you're disrupting work and, you know, the regular flow of life is what is one of the biggest challenges. Mm-hmm. Because unlike the West, you can't shut down a street and shoot. There's always going to be an enormous crowd around your shooting area and things like that. So, and we really wanted to capture the city as it is, you know, in its element.
Mm-hmm.
So we didn't want to shut a street down and put in junior artists and, you know, create shops and action. So that was a challenge to find places that had character, had, you know, had a real feel of the city and make it possible to shoot within that, with, you know, shoot our action with our actors, be invisible in some way within that. That was my big challenge on this film.
Amir, for you, how is it different from your other movies that you've shot for before this?
I mean, I don't think for me the process was any different. As it is, each film is unique and the requirement of each film is different.
Right.
And the film itself, the script itself, and often the director decides how you go about making the film.
Right.
So in that sense, every film is different and every film is unique. But by and large, what we're trying to achieve is the same. What we're trying to achieve is ki yaar jo humne script mein padha hai, jo director banana chahta hai, jo director ke dimaag mein hai, that's what we're trying to achieve. And in each script, that's a different end result. But what is common is that whatever the end result is, we are trying to reach there. So in Three Idiots is different, and this is different, where the film is going is different. And each director has his own style and his own way of achieving his vision. And as a team member, my job is to make sure that I'm at all times there to assist, there to help, there to, you know, be part of the process of what the director wants me to do. I think in this case, Kiran wanted to do it in a very unusual way of, you know, having a small crew and shooting in real locations without actually trying to interfere very little with what is actually happening around her, least amount of change of what's happening in what's already happening in the city, because she wanted to capture the, you know, the buzz, the energy,
right,
the throb of the city as
right
it is.
Right.
So that's the method that we followed in this case.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So AKP as a production house has always made some very hard hitting cinema, entertaining at the same time, but different.
Mm-hmm.
And you've said that, you know, Dhobi Ghat is the finest film that AKP has produced.
Yeah.
So what makes it different from a Tare Zameen Pe, a Lagaan, or even a Peepli Live?
I think all of these films are very fine films. Peepli, Jaane Tu, Lagaan, Tare Zameen Par, I've directed myself.
Right.
All of these are very fine films.
Mm.
Why I feel that Dhobi Ghat is a finer film, and I'm using the word fine.
Right. Yeah.
It's a word I'm choosing carefully. It's because I believe that the bariki of the work is much more fine in Dhobi Ghat. It's much more layered, it's much more nuanced, it's pitched in a more subtle way. So that's why I feel it's of a sensibility which is much more finer. It's of a taste which is much more finer. I think even as in terms of its execution or in terms of its how Kiran has conceived the scenes, how she's written the screenplay, how she's written the characters, in every way, whether it's in conceptualization, writing, or execution,
right,
I think the work is finer.
Okay.
That's my feeling.
Mm.
This is cinema, it's a subjective thing. You know, each one has their own favorites, or what you like, what you don't like.
Sure.
So, not to take away from any of the films that are my production, and I'm very proud of all of the four films that my production house has so far made. You know, Lagaan is a great film. I think Ashu's done a wonderful job. Tare Zameen Par is a wonderful film. I'm really proud of it. Jaane Tu, which Abbas made, and Peepli Life, which Anusha made.
Mm.
All of these films are films that I'm very proud of.
Mm.
And we are all very proud of. So when I say that this is finer than, the finest to come out, I know I'm saying a big thing, big statement. But I think I mean what I say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, what is the importance that is attached to International Film Festival, you know, doing the rounds with your film there? For an Indian movie, what does that mean?
Well, it's an opportunity for the film to get showcased to a different audience, more importantly to a different market. And in a sense, festivals are marketplaces, by and large, where you're hoping that people would see your film and actually buy it, and the film would then travel to that country. Or distributors who've come from different countries in the world have come to the festival, they will watch your film, they will like it, they will buy it for their own countries. And therefore, the film will actually get a much wider viewership, it will get a wider release. And you know, an Indian film will then travel to 40, 50, 60, 70 countries. You know, that's the idea of actually going to a festival, broadly speaking.
But is it true that, you know, movies that are like smaller movies, not in that sense of the term, but not with big star cast or, you know, mainstream, they mostly go to festivals and, you know, it's important for them to be there so that...
Also.
Yeah.
In fact, festivals are... You see, what I would imagine is that a big film with top international stars,
right,
they, in any case, get distribution without having to go to a festival to showcase themselves.
Sure.
The moment the film is announced, there's a distributor who wants to buy it. Sometimes the studio themselves are releasing it. Or, you know, the film is already pre-sold. The films which are small and independent, who no one has heard of, there are no stars in it, nobody wants to buy it, why will they buy this film?
Right.
So that film needs the support of a festival.
Right.
Because the festival has so many people applying, ke hamari film bhi aane, you know, people want their films to be showcased at festivals. So the film festival has a committee of people which screens these films, and they select a limited number of films. So the fact that you're selected in a film festival in itself means that your film is of a certain level, a certain quality, which the festival believes is it deserves to be showcased under their umbrella or on their platform. So the stamp of approval of that festival already comes on it.
Right.
Because they don't, you know, select all the films. For example, in when Peepli Live was selected in Sundance for the category of competition in
foreign language, international selection.
There were about 2,000 films that entered, and they selected only 18.
Right.
1-8. So 18 films out of the 2,000 entries is what they have selected.
Right.
This is what I believe that that year was the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, already you're being selected from so many films, and 18 of them are being selected.
Sure.
It indicates that it's of a very high level of quality just to be part of the festival.
Right.
So when the buyers come in, they know, okay, yaar, I can't watch 2,000 films. If I have to select which one to buy, I should watch these 18.
Right.
And I can pick what I want.
Kiran, Facebook has played a very important role in casting of your, you know, lead actresses. So, how did the process happen?
You know, I'm not on Facebook myself.
I know.
You'd be surprised to know that I have no idea how it works. And I was, you know, we were looking in very unusual places for actors. I was interested in casting non-actors. And I kind of looked through many magazines and, you know, I was also going through people's personal pictures. And my assistant Advait was on Facebook, and his Facebook pictures were, you know, up there for me to see, and I was looking through them, and I happened to see this one girl called Kriti, and she has a really kind of delicate, gentle, you know, beauty about her. Unlike photographs today where everybody strikes a pose and is very comfortable and, you know, confident, she looked very kind of shy, she looked very graceful in a very different way. And I just felt attracted to her face. So I said, you know, who is she? And he said, oh, she worked with me on a film. She's a costume assistant. She works in the wardrobe department. And we just worked on a film together. And, you know, I said, do you think she'd be interested in testing for this part? She said, I can ask, you know. And when he asked her, she was quite surprised. And I don't think she, you know, ever had an intention to get into films. But she came because she was curious to see what an audition is like. And her test was spectacular. She did, you know, she did a test that was so close to the character, without having any training, any real background. I wasn't even there for the test. I did it alone with her. And, you know, I think she has a natural gift. She was so absolutely natural in front of the camera.
Mm.
So, I'm lucky that there are these platforms now where you can get a chance to see.
And you can discover.
People with such interesting faces and, turn out to be great talents.
Yeah, sure. Speaking of Facebook, Amir, you've just crossed the 2 million fan mark on Facebook.
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah. So, how has your experience been this last 1 year?
Yeah, it's been great. I'm really happy with you know, the platform. It allows me to interact with my fans. It allows me to share with them not only my thoughts, but you know, we made all these featurettes.
Mm.
So I've been putting them up.
Mm.
On my Facebook page, so I can share so many things. I'm not the most communicative guy because I get lost. But when I'm communicating, I communicate and I really enjoy all of that. But there are times in the middle when I get completely lost and you know I don't.
You just absorb. Sometimes
I don't.
Doing.
Yeah, sometimes I don't write for a number of days.
Mm.
But I'm glad we're talking about it because I'd like you know all my fans and people who are on my page to know that nobody but me writes on my Facebook page. I don't allow anyone to write on my Facebook page. So it's always me who writes on it and I go through the comments of other people and
This is the highest ever fan base for an Indian actor on
is
Facebook.
That so?
Yes, it is.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Okay. His bloggers are missing him though.
My bloggers are complaining because since I've started on Facebook, I've not been blogging.
Okay.
But it's I've not stopped blogging because of Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
That's not the reason.
Yeah.
It's just that I've gone into a space where I'm not, you know, I do things, unless I feel like doing something, I can't do it, I find.
Yeah.
So somehow, I don't know why I've switched off from blogging for some reason. I just don't know why.
Mm-hmm.
I've thought about it often and I when I think about it, I feel I should. I miss my bloggers and I, you know, interacting with them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it's just something that has
happened.
Yeah, it happened.
Okay.
But let's see, maybe I'll start again.
Right. Okay, on a parting note, while shooting together, what were the new things that you all learnt about each other? Because you all were so close in proximity, you know, working professionally together. Was there anything new that you all learnt about each other?
What? You learned anything about me?
No, you say because I can't think.
I think that what I learned about her through the process of making this film is that, first of all, I didn't know she was such a good writer.
Mm.
I really think she's a fantastic writer. I had no idea she's such a good director.
Mm.
So these are two things I learned about her because I know that she's a lovely human being. She's someone who I, you know, love very much and respect very much and high regard for. Intellectually, you know, and emotionally, in every way. But I didn't know that as a cinema person, she's so capable and so much in control of what she's making creatively. She's very much in control. I didn't know all of that because I'd never seen that. I had never seen that side of her as a writer, as a director. So I'm very proud of that.
I think, it wasn't so much what I learned, but what I experienced. And that gave me sort of a new learning. I've worked with Amit for many years as an associate producer, you know, in production capacities. But I'd never directed him as an actor. And I feel, that whole experience was just amazing for me because, you know, I got to interact with him and I got to actually have a relationship with him where there was a certain different kind of dependence on each other.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because a director has to really nurture an actor, has to really, because you realize an actor is he's the face of your film and he's a very fragile person in that sense. You have to, and I really enjoyed doing that with him because I found that as a director, there's so much I can do, there's so much I can explore because here's an actor who can really can do anything.
Right.
And I can, you know, really mold him any way I want, and I can get fine differences in performance. And it opened me up to the world of performance as well, you know, in a sense, because I've never worked with, and all my other actors are newcomers. So it was, it really taught me a lot about performance. It really taught me how great an actor he is, because he's a really exciting actor for a director to direct. You know, you really feel free, you feel challenged.
Mm-hmm.
And I also learned to direct, actually.
Awesome. So thank you so much for talking to us, and
thank
all the
you.
Best for your release.
Thank
Pleasure.
You. Thank you.
Thank you.